Drew's travelling 113 miles south to Builth Wells in Mid Wales, home to one of his favourite antiques markets.
Good fair, big fair. You get dealers from all over Wales and the Midlands coming over for it as well.
And if the weather's nice, it's always nice. It's nice just to be outside.
Exactly.
Builth Wells is one of the UK's biggest fairs, with 1,000 stalls filling a giant agricultural showground. Most importantly for Drew, this market features plenty of high-end dealers, showcasing world-class pieces with a sprinkling of more oddball items.
Look at that rug.
How bizarre.
Look at that.
So who are they then?
I've no idea.
You're making a carpet for some people to walk on your head, aren't you?
Do you think we'll ever have our heads on it? Yeah. I want to buy quality and quantity, the best things. I have more fun buying really good pieces than anything else. This is great fun. Look at these. Walk into the first big shed. Right in front of me, there's this optician's display unit.
Bloody hell.
Optical Fashions, volume 2.
What a great thing. Lift the top up, mirror pops up, storage down both sides, maker's mark, London. It's got everything going for it, this thing. It ticks every box.
This ebonized vintage optician's sales desk would have been in the center of the shop, with sample spectacle frames stored in faux leather-bound books. An unusual piece of retail furniture, it could be worth around £1,500.
That is absolutely brilliant. I love that. Boomski. Have we got a price on this, please?
It's £650.
All right. Yeah, great, I'll have it. When you come to a fair like this, and it's first thing in the morning, if somebody gives you a price, pay it, because it will be gone. My instinct was instantly to buy that. Steel and brass. Fab, where'd you get them from?
They came out of a church in Westcliff-on-Sea, in Essex. Ah,
OK. Lighting from churches always tends to be pretty damn good quality, and they're great. Gilt metal and brass, glass insert, acid-etched, great colour, super wear, and a pair.
These gothic bronzed brass pendant lights date from around 1900. They're a scarce model, and once they've been rewired, could be worth around £1,000.
How much are these?
£220 for the pair.
For the pair. Fab. I'll have those.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, yes. The price, £220. Boom, happy days. I mean, you know, we're making money there. We are making money all day long on those. Just got to get them back without breaking them.
With literally hundreds more stalls to visit, the boys are on a roll.
How are you?
Yeah, good to see you.
Good.
Yeah, mate, how are you?
Very well.
Thanks, yourself?
Yeah, good.
Is that an embroidery really nice set in the top there?
Yeah, on satin.
This little octagonal centre table here, ebonised and parcel gilt legs on interesting casters as well. You know, this is the sort of thing I can sell all day long and also say, yeah, it's utterly authentic.
But while Drew's got his head in the deal, T's got his head in something else.
Taylor & Sons.
How much is that?
£180.
Brilliant. I didn't even see him putting that on.
No, I didn't either. What's that standard?
Straight from the horse's master.
Is that best on here, 180?
180. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Marvellous.
Great stuff, matey.
And it's not long before Drew's expert eye is drawn to another standout piece.
You do like a settle.
There's settles and there's settles. Every now and again, you'll see something, and it's so good, it goes beyond the bounds.
Don't recognise the style. Where's it from?
West Country, I think.
Yeah.
Everyone is so unique.
It's quite exciting, isn't it? It's very exciting.
Settles originated in Europe in the 10th century, with high backs to protect from the drafts of medieval buildings. This rare English pine example is in the Arts and Crafts Manor and dates from around 1880. It has excellent form and is in original condition, so could be worth around £2,500.
It's an absolute beauty. Wonderful.
Utterly untouched. Never had a thing done to it in its life. An easy life as well, just faded into the beauty that it is now. I can't not buy that.
Do 1,100?
Can't.
Damn it. 12.
Cheers. Thank you very much.
It's so good, you could charge an awful lot of money for that and just sit and wait, because you're not going to find one better of that style. It's superb. There's fairs all over the country, but for sheer quality, this one is smashing it completely. To be able to buy lamps like that, that fabulous settle, you know, I bought several things that are just absolutely top-notch.
The van's almost full, but Drew spotted yet another star item.
That's a little gem, isn't it?
Nice
thing. Genuine. God, that's not had anything done. There's no repairs. They're all gone. Usually one of the legs has been changed. They're all dead, right? Well, it's at least 200 years old. The man that made that would recognise it today. It's a wonderful thing. It may be one of the best ones left in existence.
Windsor chairs first appeared in the early 18th century. Constructed of chair back and leg spindles socketed into a saddle-shaped seat, this early 19th century example is unrestored, and with traces of the original paint still visible, could be worth around £1,800.
What's the death on it?
The 600.
That's it. I can't not look at it. It's perfection, isn't it?
The piece that really is the outstanding piece of the day, and it's got some fairly stiff competition, is that chair. It's just a wonderful piece in every respect, and I have enjoyed today immensely. Sun shining, I'm in Wales, I'm buying antiques. Just perfect.